Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, I'm going to be teaching you how to make architectural sections using SketchUp. All right, so I imported this model from the 3D warehouse. There's a link to it down in the description below. And the first thing that I want to do is just make sure that my section planes are on. So go to View and make sure that Section Planes is checked here. And then over here on the right side, there's the section plane tool. If you don't have this toolbar, you can just right click in a white space and just make sure that you have, it's called large tool set. You just make sure that's checked. And I like to dock mine over on this left side here. There's also another place to make a section tool in the menu. Yeah, so under tools, there's also section plane if you don't want to make this new toolbar. So just be aware of that. So section plane, I'm just going to click that. I've made some sections before in this model. By default, it will say section one and then have a symbol. So you can do that. This is SketchUp 2018 Pro. So that's a feature in this. I don't remember this being in older versions. So I'm not sure exactly when this was implemented, but it's really helpful if you're going to lay out eventually to start thinking about your sections and how you're naming them. For now, I'm just going to leave this as section three, symbol three, because I don't want to make it interfere with anything. Now what's going to happen is it's going to give you the section plane and you need to place that. So you can see it's sort of going all over the place. It's kind of confused. What it's doing is it's referencing the planes that I'm mousing over as the section plane. Like this green is perpendicular to this axis here. The green or the blue is a horizontal plane, and then red is perpendicular to this axis as well. So this can be a hassle sometimes if you want to sort of like click in the middle here, but get it to be on, let's say, the green axis. Right now it seems like it's doing it okay, or actually it just changed to white. What you can do is actually press the arrow keys on your keyboard. So if you press up, it'll lock to the blue axis, right will lock to the red, and green will lock to, or left will lock to the green axis. Really helpful tip when you're doing sections, because it can go haywire really quickly. We are going to start making a red section through the middle of this. I'm just going to click the center point of here, and you can see I get a really nice section through the middle. Now I've opened up scenes here. You want to make sure that if you're doing multiple sections, it can get really confusing really quickly. So I would recommend opening scenes. So you go to window default tray, and then make sure your scenes tab is selected. And then in your default tray, you'll have this little drop down bar. Hold on a second. Just lost everything. scenes, there we go. Let me just delete one of these and I'll make a new one. So let me turn my section planes back on. So I have this guy. I'm gonna hit the plus arrow to add a scene. Now you can see down here, I have a bunch of stuff checked. The thing that you wanna make sure that is definitely checked for this is active section planes. That's gonna allow you to switch back and forth between what you're seeing. So right now this is actually deactivated. So I just wanna activate, I just right clicked on my plane. Went to active cut. And then we'll change that to an active cut. So that's really helpful. And then, you know, pick your camera view. Maybe helpful. Maybe you want a straight on view. That I know that's pretty popular. You just want to go to standard view. Let's try right. Yeah, looks like it. So, and you can see everything sort of grayed out a little bit. That's because of the section plane. There's a section plane and a section cut. The cut is the literal cut, and then the plane gives sort of like a hue to everything. So what I like to do is turn off section planes when I'm doing this, and then just update my scene. That way I can see right on. And always when you're doing scenes, just do the due diligence of giving this a name. So we're gonna say a short section through bedroom. Okay, so that's a nice name for that. It's very descript. So and we could even say Let's click on this again. Short section. Maybe even we'll add 2D. Short 2D section. Because we may like this, but then I want to add a scene using this same view and then go to perspective. So it's very similar, but it has more depth now. And then I'm just going to update that. So we have this guy and then we have this guy. You get two different sections. Now, the other thing that I wanted to show you with this, when I have section planes on, is that you can right click on your section plane and go to create group from slice. Now, what that's going to do is make a really nice line drawing of the section. You can see it's kind of wonky here because of the section plane. Actually, I'm not sure exactly why it's so wonky. It's like strobing. But if you want to import this into Illustrator or CAD or something, it's a really nice line work to easily bring in. Before you do that, and whenever you do a section, you may want to consider turning off some of the extra things that you have, like this bed is kind of weird to have in a section, to be cutting through that as well, and the couch and things like that. So that may be something you want to put all of your accessories and furniture on a separate layer, just for clarity's sake. We just come back in here, rename this. I'm going to change this to 3D. Okay. So we have that. And then let's say we want to add another one, but we want to have a section plane going in a different direction. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to deactivate this cut, select my section plane again. I'm using the arrow keys here, the left key to get that green axis. So it's going this way. I don't really see much of the building. So what I'm going to do is right click on this and hit reverse. It'll change the direction of my section cut. Again, turn off my section planes. I want a really nice, I don't want this view, I want back. I want a really nice perspective drawing, so I'm just gonna hit back there. And you can see I'm off of the green axis. Probably I should have set that down so that it's a quadrant is here. Or a part of my model is actually on the ground plane, but it is what it is at this point. So I'm gonna update my scene again. And now I can really easily, you can see there's an animation going. The section is actually changing. The section cut animates between these two. But I get a really nice section through that as well. So hopefully this helped. I guess the last thing, you can see the animation is going on between, and that can get really annoying if you're not planning on actually doing an animation. And depending on how complex your model is, it can slow things down. So check the description below for a link to how to stop the animation. I have a video that shows how to do that. If you guys like this, please don't hesitate to let me know. Leave a like, subscribe, and as always, happy hacking.
All right, designers, just because this episode of Designer Hacks is over doesn't mean we're leaving you out in the cold. Tony's got tons of great content available at designerhacks.com. So join Design Nation right now, and we'll see you on the next episode of Designer Hacks.